When you see the next sum, see what is given to you. It's a purely proving sum. There's no figure, nothing given to you. And such sums are very interesting sum. In fact, I want to say they are bit on a difficult side. Don't worry. I will be there with you to help you out. We read the sum. What is given to you? Prove that a diameter of a circle, that means one diameter. What happened to this diameter? See what is given. Perpendicular to one of the two parallel chords. That means there are two chords in the circle given to you and both the chords are parallel. And this diameter is perpendicular to one of the chord. Okay, what else? Of a circle is perpendicular to the other. We have to prove it's perpendicular to the other chord also. And it bisects that chord. That means this diameter is nothing but what giving rise to one 90 degree angle and it's bisecting the other chord. Okay, let's draw one circle now. There's nothing given to you. It's an imaginary circle now with the center what? O. And let the two required parallel chords be chord AB and chord CD, what are given to you. And let the required diameter be diameter EF. That's what I have taken in the figure. What else I've done? I've joined, see what I've given over here. See what is given over here to you. Given angle OGB is 90 degree. Because they said it's what perpendicular. So angle OGB is what 90 degree. What is G over here? G is nothing but a point on what a chord AB. What else given to you? EF is the diameter. What else? Is B is what parallel to what CD. AB is what parallel to CD. These all things are given to you. Further, what is there? Construction. Yes, we are going to what construct now. Construction. Join OC and what OD. Further down, what do we get? Now we start solving it. Solution part of it. How to go for it? Just see. We take two triangles. Triangle what OCH and triangle what ODH. When you see these two triangles very carefully, so what do you get in this? We get OC is equal to what OD. These are the radius of the same circle. We get OC equal to what OD, the two radius of the same circle. What else? We get angle OGB is equal to what angle OHD, which is nothing but equal to angle OHC because they all are 90 degree. This you get because of the transversal property and you get because AB is parallel to what CD. Okay, beautiful. Then what do you have? OH is a common side in both the triangles. By taking all these three properties, what I get? I get two triangles. Which two triangles? Triangle OCH is congruent to triangle ODH. By which test? SAS test of congruency. Side, angle, side, test of congruency. These two triangles become what? Congruent. Now, because two triangles are congruent, what I get? I get two sides which are what equal. That is, I get side CH equal to what side DH. Corresponding sides of congruent triangles. That is, and what I get? I get OHD is equal to what 90 degree. Because one is 90, other has to be 90. Because that is what equal to 180 degree, linear pair. So finally what I get? I get CH equal to what DH. I have to prove that it bisects the other chord. Bisects matlab, I want to prove that CH is equal to what DH. That's we have already done. And we also prove that angle, which angle? OHD is equal to 90 degree. These were the two things which are required in this sum. Now see what is given the next following sum, the concluding sum of this chapter. See what is given to you. Prove that the line joining the midpoint, midpoint of what? See the sum very carefully. Midpoint of a chord to the center of the circle passes through the midpoint of the corresponding minor arc. In short, what is given? There is one line, there is one segment which is passing through the chord and which divides the arc into two equal halves. It's a very interesting sum, slightly difficult, because the entire thing has to go on assumption, because we don't know where the circle is, no figure given to you. So you have to construct the circles on your own. Let's start with the basic thing first. Let's go for a construction of a circle with center O. That's what I've done. Let's take a chord, and the chord which is taken by me is the chord AB. So let chord AB be the required chord given to you in the circle. And let OR be the segment which divides the chord into two equal halves. Then what I have to prove? I have to prove that arc AXR is equal to arc BYR. This is what to be proved, they are equal. Now how to go for it? We'll go for an easy method. We'll try to make this some very simple for you. Join first of all OA and OB. When you join OA and OB, they are the radius of the same circle. The moment you join, you start feeling you're getting what triangle. What else you draw? What else you do? See, what you have, OM is perpendicular on what? AB. Why OM is perpendicular? Because the line which is perpendicular from the center will bisect the chord in two equal half. And it's already given, this line which is what OR is bisecting the given chord. When the OR is bisecting what AB, that means OM has to be what? Perpendicular on what AB. Very important part of it. Now we get two triangles, two right angle triangles. Which two triangles we have? We have triangle OMA and we have triangle OMB. We'll try to prove these two triangles are what? Congruent. How do you go for it? What do you have in these two triangles? Let's see. We have got OA is equal to what? OB. Yes, these are the radius of the same circle. OA is equal to what? OB. Radius of the same circle. What else? OM is equal to what? OM. That's what, a common side. And it's already given to you. AM is equal to what? BM. Because OR is bisecting the chord. So finally, what you get? These two triangles are what? Congruent. By which test? SSS test of what? Congruency. Side, side, side test of what? Congruency. And the moment two triangles become congruent, their corresponding angles also what? Equal. So what do we get? Angle AOM is equal to angle BOM. That is corresponding angles of congruent triangles. That is nothing but AOR is equal to BOR. That's just an extension of it. So what I get finally? I get arc AXR is equal to arc BYR. Why? Because equal angles always substand equal arcs. I repeat once again, equal angles will substand what? Equal arc. That is what we have proved, is a line joining the midpoint of the chord is bisecting the minor arc into two equal halves. That is, we have proved arc AXR is equal to arc BYR. That's very clear to you. A line joining the midpoint is bisecting the minor arc into two equal parts. Let's see this chapter, that is chord properties from the ICAC board examination point of view. A very important chapter. Definitely something is there in the paper on the chord properties. But from the past experience, what you have seen, a separate question does not come nowadays on only on chord properties. A chord property can be combined with what? Tangent properties or alternate segment properties or angle properties. These are all the properties which can be combined together and made one or two or three sums. It can be either in section A or section B. But normally it is in what? Section B. or one simple question can come in what section A also. So we have to be mentally prepared for it. The weightage approximately 3 to 4 marks. So chord properties coming with along with other properties of circles. Approximately 4 marks, one question. Let's see one question which has come in the board exam. Long back it was. In the March 1980. Read the sum what was given to us. Let's go over a sum. In a circle of radius 5 cm. So there is a circle, one circle of radius what? 5 cm. What is given? AB and CD are two parallel chords. Okay, so the assumption is not required over here. Because they are given there are two chords and that is what AB and CD. And the measurements are also given to you, that is 8 and 6 cm. So 8 cm and 6 cm. AB and CD. So AB is definitely 8 cm. And CD is what? 6 cm. These are the two chords, which are what? Parallel chords. Chords are parallel. What else? Calculate the distance between these two chords. We have to find the distance between the two chords. Remember that we have done one sum on the same type? Yes. Now you can think much more faster. What do you have to find now? The distance between these two chords, if the chords are on the same side of the circle and if the chords are on the opposite sides of the center. Let's start first solving the sum when the both the chords are on the same side of the center. Now draw the figure now. Two chords AB and CD on the same side of the center. You can see the figure now. The chord which is bigger will be nearer to the center. As we go away from the center, the size of the chord get what? Reduced. So chord CD is what? 6 cm. And chord AB is what? 8 cm. What we do over here? We draw perpendiculars onto chord AB and chord what? CD. Let OM be what? Perpendicular on what? AB. And ON be perpendicular on what? CD. And if we revise once again, perpendicular from the center to the chord will bisect the chord into equal half. That's why what I get? I get MB is equal to what? 4 cm. That's half of 8. And I get ND is equal to what? 3 cm. That is half of what? 6. So when you see the figure now very carefully, we have got two triangles now. Two right angle triangles. By using Pythagoras theorem, what we can find? First taking triangle OMB. What I get? OB square is equal to MB square plus OM square. Putting the values into the formula, what I get? 25 minus what? 16 is equal to OM square. That is OM is equal to what? 3 cm. Because OM square is what? 9. And root of 9 is nothing but what? 3. Further down, if I take a triangle now, OND. In this triangle, what I get? OD square is equal to MD square plus what? ON square. By putting the values into the formula, what I get? 5 square is equal to 3 square plus what? ON square. So ON square is equal to 25 minus 9, that is what? 16. And ON is nothing but what? 4. So the distance between these two chords is nothing but MN. And how do you get MN? 4 minus 3 cm, that is what? 1 cm. So the distance between the two chords, if the two chords are on the same side of the center, is nothing but 1 cm. Now in the second part of the same question, we have to find the distance between two chords when they are on the opposite side of the center. When they are on the opposite side of the center. See what you are doing. First step, draw a perpendicular OM on the chord AB. Now this perpendicular will divide the chord into equal half. That's why MB will become what? 4 cm, half of it. Similarly, draw ON perpendicular onto what? CD. That means ND will become what? 3 cm. By using Pythagoras theorem, in triangle OMB, what do we get? 25 minus 16 is equal to what? OM square. That is, 9 is equal to what? OM square. So OM is equal to what? 3 cm. Similarly, in triangle OND, by using Pythagoras theorem, I get 25 minus 9 is equal to ON square. That is, 16 is equal to ON square. And ON is what? 4. but I have to find the distance. That is what MN. MN is what? 3 plus 4 centimeter, which is what? 7 centimeter. The distance between the two chords, which are what? Apart from each other, they are on the opposite side of the centers. Now let's summarize the entire chapter of chord properties. In short, let's see what we have done in this chapter. Let's go for a recap of it. It is very simple and small and easy chapter. But still, a small recap will definitely help you. To start with, we picked up the sums where we found the distance between the two chords. Which two chords? The chords which are what? Parallel. We did the sums when two chords on the same side of the center. We did the sums when two chords are on the opposite side of the center. After doing the sums successfully, we went on to the proving sums, where we proved two chords are what equal. We also proved two arcs are equal. These were some of the few sums which have taken care of this chapter, that is what chord properties. And I hope you must have done this very neatly, very clearly. I feel that you will get more confidence by doing more sums with more practice. So take keen interest into this chapter and gain the confidence.